And what's up, everyone? Happy Friday and welcome back to the Daily Pfav. This is episode 76 for Friday, June 15th, 2018. The time is now 6:15 p.m. here on the East Coast. And so this weekend, specifically tomorrow, is a huge photography weekend for me. I have two major gigs booked. And so tomorrow I am going to be shooting, I think, for the seventh or eighth time, the NPC Championships here in Pittsburgh. And that is a bodybuilding and fitness competition, male-female. And like I said, I've been doing that for about 4 years now. And so I got to start getting all my camera equipment ready for that, charging all the batteries, cleaning all the lenses, reformatting all the SD cards, repacking the gear bags, and doing all that fun stuff that goes into the pre-shoot preparation. And then follow that up with, I'm doing another celebrity photo shoot as soon as I'm done shooting that. So I've technically double booked myself for tomorrow, but in the photography world, that's the name of the game, and sometimes that's how it works. You end up booking one event, and then you get a phone call to shoot something else, specifically celebrities, and it's like, okay, yeah, I can do that, and I can make that happen, and so that's what I'm going to do. So tomorrow's going to be like this crazy maniac day of running around all over town shooting, and so we'll see how that turns out. I'm not anticipating any issues or any problems. And no, I'm not going to tell you who the celebrity is. You got to wait and see the pictures whenever I post them, probably tomorrow night on social media. But the bodybuilding shows are a lot of fun. They're very interesting to shoot. And obviously, it always makes me feel like shit every time I go shoot one of these because, you know, here comes these perfectly, you know, chiseled, you know, guys and girls out on stage and, you know, talking about their diets and their fitness. And it's like, oh my God. And, you know, usually I've just rolled in smelling like a Big Mac and a large fry combo. but yeah, they're unique to shoot and they're very challenging from a photography, point of view to shoot because, you know, you kind of got to learn, you know, their routines and how they pose, know when the right moment is to shoot so that you get the maximum muscular pose that they're trying to show the judges. You want to make sure that you capture that angle at the right moment. And, you know, the biggest challenging thing about this, right, and just go with me here for a second, is because all of these competitors apply some kind of the tanning lotion or the tanning spray. And it makes them, they're either brown or they're either orange. Like, I think I'm saying that right. I mean, there's, to me, those are the two colors that they are. And then what makes it worse is they come out on stage and they're under these, you know, LED lights that just, it just creates a weird look on a raw file. And so thank God it is a raw file, because then when I edit those pictures, I have to go in and manually adjust the white balance and try to make it look as close to the natural eye as I remember whenever I took the picture. You can't rely on the camera to do auto white balance for that. So there is a lot of, you know, that may end up being 2 hours worth of shooting, and then that ends up being, I don't know, 8 to 10 hours worth of editing those competition pictures and getting them right and getting them uploaded to a gallery for the competitors to download and purchase. And so, yeah, so that's kind of what tomorrow is. So that should be a fun and exciting show. I always enjoy those. I always get to meet a lot of people, talk to a lot of people, and, you know, it's kind of fun whenever they get done. There's a local Chinese restaurant at the waterfront that always, I don't know if it's the show that actually buys them all dinner, but they literally come in with like 20 or 30 bags of these meals, And these guys and gals just go to town whenever they're done. So it's pretty unique to watch. But hey, you know, they deserve it. You know, they do all that training and everything like that to get themselves to look that way for these competitions. So it's just fun. It's just a fun time to sit back and watch that and document that for them. And again, I'm looking forward to this celebrity shoot tomorrow. I'm really hoping that the person is cool in person because I think I've talked about it in the past. You know, I do. If you've seen my portfolio online, I have shot a lot of celebrities. You know, I've done a lot of headshots for celebrities and shot a lot of them doing their craft, whether it's comedy or singing or whatever. It doesn't matter. And I would say 95% of them are cool human beings. And, you know, they get it. They understand what I'm there to do. And, you know, they work with me and just let me do my thing. And every now and then, you just get that, you know, that A-lister type that comes in and they're just a pain in the butt and they don't want to cooperate and they're difficult to work with. So I don't know about this one. I've yet to hear back from the people as to what they are like when they're not performing. So nevertheless, we'll see. But again, I'll try to do you know, my best and do what I do, and hopefully tomorrow night's podcast, whenever I get home, although I suspect it'll be late, I will get something up on social media for everyone to see. And I'm going to leave it right there for tonight. It's been a busy week, and it's too pretty of a Friday to sit inside and podcast. So I think I'm headed out to my porch. 412-701-4323 is the show call-in number. PaulFalavolitoPodcast.com. And as always, thank you so much for listening.